showed you the altercation between Brad Keselowski's team and the 20 of Denny Hamlin. This is one of the reasons why, guys. This is May of last year.
Yeah, it's not the first time these two drivers have been together on the racetrack. And right here, another little fisticuff broke out at Charlotte after that.
Now, late in this race, this is what happened as the laps were closing down. The contact, Denny ends up into the wall.
Yeah, Brad thought he had a run and enough room on the inside, but Denny was just driving his car back to as they were trying to go around the lap car. And then after the race, Denny
Hamlin
just comes to pit road.
Just a few moments ago, and now let's check in with Jamie Little.
Well, a little reminiscing there, Brad, and you watched it too. So first of all, I want to know what happened between you guys on the track, and was it your fault or his fault, and then what happened afterwards?
Well, I got to congratulate Clint first. Great guy, deserves to win. Happy to see him in Victor Lane, so congratulations to him. But we had a great GoDaddy.com Chevrolet. I made mistakes early in the race, got us behind, and the car was just good enough to drive back up there. And we got up behind Denny, I think it was maybe 10 to go, or 25 to go. I just couldn't get by him. He had a good car as well, and just had an opportunity. He left a hole to pass him, and, you know, at this level, it's different than other levels because we have spotters, and I know for sure my guys already told me that his spotter told me I was down there, and he just tried to take advantage of me. And I'm not going to be pushed around. So I tried to take advantage of me, and I had to make a decision of whether to let him or not. And the rest is history. But that's the way it goes sometimes. The same thing could have happened when he tried to get by me, but I gave him the spot and knew it was there, and he just didn't extend the same courtesy.
Did that surprise you, seeing him and his posse kind of down there and talking to you guys?
I don't know. I don't really put too much into that. But, I can understand being upset. His team works hard on the race cars just like mine. And I don't like to see anybody's race car get tore up like his did. That's a tough weekend for his team. But, he had a choice. He could have gave me a lane and finished fourth or fifth or whatever it was. But he tried to take advantage of me. You know, he had the choice and he knew I was there.
That was the incident. Let's talk about what you did today, though. You had an incident on pit road, as you mentioned. You missed pit road. Then you guys had a speeding penalty, went a lap down, and you still fought back. If you had a couple more laps, did you have a good enough car to get this win?
Yeah, I think about 20 laps or so, I could have caught up to Clint and gave him a run for the money. I don't know if I could have got by him. I needed about, two or three more laps to get by Mike, who's, great run for him. I'm happy for Mike. He's a good friend of mine. And so we had a strong enough car just didn't have enough laps to get up there and show what we had with Clint. But he deserves a win, too. So.
Nice job today, Brad.
Hey, it's more a reaction to him. I was just sitting in the motorhome when y'all came up listening to that idiot talk. He has no idea how to race. He thinks he's in there if he drives in 20 car lengths deeper to get his nose in there. He's not. He never had position on me whatsoever. He had just got to me, so he never even made an attempt to pass us clean. But, that's why, he'll get a ride and he'll hang around for a couple of years and people realize that he's not really that good.
Were you getting communication on the radio from your spotter that he was there?
Yeah, they said he was looking inside, and of course I had position. I was trying to get to the 18, and he just drove in there extremely hard just to get his nose in there. But he just took the first opportunity that he had to get to us and just showed no patience. But, that's Brad.
What were you going to say if you would have gotten to him once you got to out of the car on pit lane? Or when you got to him there on pit lane, what did you say?
Well, I wanted to talk to him, and, he obviously needs some kind of guidance on, what he needs to do to make it. And he's got a ton of talent. I'm not going to take that away from him. He's a good driver, and if he can harness it, he'll win a lot more races. But, he just, at the cup level, he'll realize it, a lot of it is he doesn't have a lot of cup experience, which that's okay. He's getting there. But once he starts to get out there on Sunday and see how to race, he'll realize that in his younger years, he didn't do it the right way.
Appreciate you coming out in the rain. Yep. Denny Hamlin. Thanks, Denny.